What's up, you guys? We're back.
We are back!
On this adventure, we're rolling down south to a tropical paradise. Puerto Vallarta. Back in the 1800s, this town used to be known as Las Peñas, meaning the rocks, named after the rugged mountain formations that peaked over the coastline. Then, in 1918, the people of Mexico changed the name to Puerto Vallarta, in honor of their love for former governor Ignacio Vallarta, one who had a profound influence on the town's development.
We just landed at the airport. I'm gonna show you what it's like because there's a lot of hustlers trying to get you to take a ride with them, saying, oh, you can't leave until you book with us, or oh no, where are you going? We'll take you there. So I'll give you guys the ins and outs of where we're going. But outside the airport right now, there's actually a pedestrian bridge that goes across to the other side where Ubers, taxis, and everything's cheaper. Do not get a taxi here because they will like rip you off like crazy. All right, guys, so that's the airport. And like I said, if you keep walking down, there's a pedestrian bridge right here that leads you to taxis that are over there that are way cheaper than the ones that are over here. So we're gonna head over there right now. All right, guys, so we're over the pedestrian bridge. We're waiting for the taxis now. Let me see if I can flip it, hold on. So these are where the Ubers and taxis come. That's in the opposite side of the airport. Like I said, just take that pedestrian bridge all the way over here and you'll save a lot more money.
We're starting our adventure at the Hotel Tropicana, a true icon of Puerto Vallarta. Built in the 1940s as a private residence, it was later transformed into a hotel in the 1950s, welcoming guests and icons such as Lucille Ball, John Lennon, and even former President Nixon, with its classic Mexican charm and stunning ocean views.
So this is the premier room at the Hotel Tropicana. It's a really big space, you guys. Now, before I show you out there, it looks like they're doing some construction, so there is a scaffolding, but it does not obstruct our view. Hey. All right, you guys, are you ready? Check out the view from our room. So this is the Hotel Tropicana. That's building number one. We're in building number two. The entrance is over there. This is the resort. You have a little beach hut. You guys have a pool back there. And then all of this is our beachfront property. We are in Zone Romantica, which is the romantic zone in Puerto Vallarta. It's spaced out by different zones. When I first went here, I went here with my friends, the Foos. They actually brought me here for the first time. It actually changed my perspective on how I want to travel because they literally just had a backpack. I am the type that brings luggage, as you could see, but they literally just had a backpack, one pair of shoes, and they're just like, let's go. We'll figure it out when we get there. So our first trip here really opened my eyes to traveling and what traveling could be. So shout out to the Foos. Thank you so much. But yeah, we are just freshening up right now before we head out. I forgot we have a dinner reservation. We were gonna walk to my favorite taco spot, but I think we're gonna save that for tomorrow. I'll give you the name and all that later on when she sees it, so we could all get surprised together. But like I said, we're freshening up. We're gonna head to Oxxo, which is like their 7-Eleven here in Mexico. So we're gonna go there, just grab a little refreshments and something to like hold us steady until dinner time. And then once we leave here, I'll show you guys around and we'll go from there. Okay, now that Nicolette's out of the bathroom, let me show you this bathroom as well, you guys. Also, my Hong Kong video, like I told you, this is your power. So your room key is your power. But look at this bathroom. Hey, it's so huge. Jesus, I don't know if you could really tell, but this is a really big bathroom. All right, guys, so now we're gonna head to Oxxo, like I said, to get refreshments and drinks. We'll show you guys the beach, and then we have to get ready for dinner, so let's go.
Tiny elevator.
Bigger than the one in Paris still.
Yes, there's room to move around. Woo! Pizza is only 180 euros. I mean, pesos. You said Paris. Put it in my head. Okay. And now we're ready for some food.
This is the lobby of this hotel, yeah. You guys. Check this out. It's crazy.
Even a mural over there. The view of the ocean from here.
guys, most of the roads here are off cobblestone. So the car rider would just like.
Oh, whoa. That's a nice mural. Ocean over there. I smell that. There's a disturbance in the forest.
And before you guys judge me, Nicolette is walking behind me because I know where I'm going, so she's following. I'm not leaving her, even though it may seem like that. She is following me.
I'm just along for the ride. Yeah, it's so vibrant. Oh, it's pet friendly. I wonder what that is. Oh, I think it's a hotel.
Well, you guys should stop.
Interesting.
Is that what you want me to wear?
No. To each their own, but that's not mine. There's another nice sugar skull mural over there.
Right here, look how close that was, you guys. We're awesome.
Oxxo.
See. Last time I was here, I got one of these because it's a little variety pack of everything.
Oh, I don't even know what Pinkitos is.
And it's blue, so that's why I like it. So we're gonna have one of these.
Makes sense. They also have different varieties of that. Oh, they even have a Ruffles mix.
Yeah. You want one of those too?
Sure, let's try it. What are the salsa queso?
Salsa negra, queso, oh, and mega crunch.
We saw that in the store the other day. Cool. Going full circle. We don't drink beer, so.
Some drinks.
What we do need.
Oh yeah, so they have the electrolytes. These are really good, guys, if you're hungover. Just saying. Not from experience. Maybe from experience, but just saying it's really good.
It's definitely from experience.
Shut up.
There was water in the room, but we should probably get a bottled water that's cold.
I forgot what drink I got here last time, you guys, but it was really cool. I like that.
Looking for, yes, oh, it's tiny. I still kind of want it though. So one of the last times I was in Mexico, it was before I was allergic to apples. And now that I've grown out of the allergy, I want it again. It's over here.
I got more snacks.
Grabbing snacks. Oh. Okay. Hola.
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 Hola. What's up?
It's all gonna fit in the bag.
It's great.
It's okay.
Yeah. Gracias, hermano.
Gracias.
Bye.
Here in February, you guys, the weather is beautiful. It's not humid, there's a nice light breeze, but it's not cold. And it's about 3 p.m. in the afternoon, so there's this really nice weather. So I recommend coming here in February. The last time I came here was in October. It was gloomy and rainy. The weather was still okay, but the sun wasn't out as much as it is right now.
December through April or May is considered the dry season here.
Also on top of that, it's actually whale season, you guys. So there's lots of whales migrating here. So we might see a whale or two in the Oxxo.
That would be
hopefully
cool.
We can catch that for you guys on video. Okay, we're gonna head back to the hotel, freshen up, and then we'll see you guys later. All right, guys, so we found this little hole-in-the-wall restaurant, and they sell tortas here on top of jugos and agua frescas, I think, yeah. So we're stopping to get a little bit of a snack inside of us before dinner. We don't want anything too big, but we were just walking by and this is next to our hotel. Oh, yeah. So we're gonna try this out. And we're back. Yeah. So I moved the table outside so at least we could have the scenery of not only this beautiful awning, but the beach too. So like I said, we stopped by this little hole in the wall and she made us a little torta. This is a torta cubana. It just has a lot of different things in it. I'm not sure what's inside of it, but we're gonna try it. And then we also got a variety of chips. Yes. So we have paque toxo. Don't get mad at me if I'm butchering the names because I don't know, but it's what we have. We have this one and it's like a little variety pack.
We have papas caseras.
Ooh.
It's like potato chips, I guess.
Chicharrones.
Which looks delicious as always.
And then we have a Ruffles mix, which has salsa negra, which I've never had. They have queso in the States, so I've tried that one, but the queso here is different. I'm not sure if it's made differently or what, but it tastes different. And then we have a mega crunch flaming hot.
We also have water, which is super important, and manzanita soda.
Manzanita soda, which is like an apple
soda.
Yeah, apple soda. And then I got the electrolyte, I'm assuming, that I told you was really good for hangovers or if you've been feeling groggy. And this is the uva, which is great. So I'm gonna try this out for you guys and tell you how it feels. Nicolette needs help. Do you need help?
Cancer.
There's that. Good. What does it taste like?
It tastes like a sweeter Martinelli's apple sparkling.
Sparkling.
The Martinelli's apple sparkling.
Oh, sparkling cider. And this tastes like a watered down grape Kool-Aid. But like I said, it's filled with electrolytes, so it's good for you. Okay, no, I didn't like that. I like apple cider, but I don't like that. And she doesn't like that either. So perfect. That's why we got our own drinks. Oh, there's someone climbing behind us. All right, I'm excited for this torta because like I said, we haven't ate yet. So let me show you what this is. This is the torta that we got. So it looks like there's lettuce, queso fresco, which is like a Mexican fresh cheese, ham, tomato, jalapenos, onions. I'm not sure if you guys could see all that. It was 110 pesos, which is
$6.43.
Which is pretty good for a torta because a torta in the States, the cheapest one I bought, I think, is maybe around 10 bucks, 8 yeah. bucks. But let's try this out.
A combination one would be like
more.
12,
oh, you guys, and there's other different meats in there too. It looks like there's chicken. Like I said, there's the chicken, the cheese, lettuce. Wow, look at that, you guys. And the bread is so warm and soft. And like I said, we were just walking and this girl had her door open and we read the menu and we're like, let's try it out. It's pretty good. The napkins got wet though. So we may need some more napkins. But yeah, now that she took a bite, show you guys the inside of that. So there's chicken, cheese, tomato, jalapeno, onions, ham, lettuce, mayonnaise. So I'm guessing it's like the combo type sandwich, but it's really good. The bread is what's getting me. It's really soft and really warm.
Yeah, it's soft, but it also has like little crunchy edges, which is so good.
And since she's so close to the hotel, I wouldn't mind going back there. But honestly, you guys, every single corner, there's a food stall, there's a food vendor, there's a food cart, a little hole in the wall, so you can't go starving here. Okay, first we're gonna open up these ruffles. This is the queso. Like I said, I'm not sure if it's because it's in Mexico or if they use different ingredients here, but, or even if it's mixed, but the flavors taste way more intense out here. This is the mega crunch. Watch out, it's dripping on you, all over you. This is the mega crunch flaming hot. Spicy. There's lemon. I don't like lemon in my chips, and it doesn't say there's lemon, but it has a lemon aftertaste, unless that's coming from the salsa negra. So this is the salsa negra. Let's test this out. The lime is coming from the salsa negra, and oh my god, that salsa is spicy. Let me try.
You try this. I'm gonna go for the mega crunch. It's bright red and obvious in the bag. That's really crunchy. Mm-hmm. That's also like that. When you eat the queso one last, you can tell like how much crunchier the other two flavors are, which is
yeah. All right. Since we are in Mexico, chicharrones is next. I don't know, you guys. I just saw a bunch of chips at Oxxo, and I was like, let's try this. So I'm not sure if these are any good or what, but so far, so good. Oh, and it comes with little sauce packets. Yay.
Oh, that's exciting.
But chicharrón? You can't mess up a chicharrón. And if you do mess it up, you're doing something wrong because it's really hard to mess these up.
Yeah. Although still nothing will be the chicken skin.
Oh, the chicken skin from the Philippines. Okay, next is the paki toxo, pig toxo, paki toxo. I don't know. And this one comes with Cheeto Puffs, Doritos 3D, which was one of my favorite chips growing up. They discontinued it in the States, so when I saw this in Mexico, I like freaked out. But it only comes in a combo pack. I haven't seen any that come by itself. Let me see if I could find one for you guys just to show you. But
It's literally a 3D Dorito that's like a little puff. And these would be my little snacks growing up as a kid.
Twisty
thing. That is a Crujitos or a Cheetos Palomitas.
Oh no, that just has the other flavors.
Unless this is the Cheetos. Oh no.
No, that's the Cheetos.
This is a Cheetos puff. Which is a Cheeto puff. Oh my god. I thought someone fell. Yeah, I think that's the Cheetos Palomitas thing.
Yeah, because I think the...
Oh no, that might be the Crujitos actually. Because there's popcorn in here too. Oh. So this might be the Crujitos. Like I said, let us know in the comments because I'm not sure, but these are really good.
See what?
Oh no, everything fell, but it's mostly puffs on the top. So I can't find the other one. Oh, there we go. And we have the popcorn.
Ah, yes. So that is...
The swirly ones?
The swirly ones are the Crujitos, because Palomitas means popcorn.
There we go. Good. And last but not least, our little potato chips in a bag. Also comes with salsa. I think I'll open the salsa for this one. So you open it.
There we go.
So it's just a little hot sauce packet, which complements the chips. But let's try the chip by itself first. These looked like fresh chips, that's why I wanted to get them, but see how they taste. That is super crunchy.
Oh wow.
And it's a really thick potato too. It's not like the Lay's that you get in the States, how it's like thin and like airy. No, not airy. It's super thin. This is like a really thick piece of potato and it has a nice crunch to it.
Yeah, it's like you can tell that it's like feels like it's more hand cut. Instead of machine cut.
And there's a little bit of hot sauce on there. The hot sauce definitely complements the chip. This sandwich is really good, you guys. Okay, we're gonna finish eating the sandwich. We're not gonna finish all the chips, don't worry. We still have dinner to get to, but we just wanted to open it and try it out and let you guys know what it tastes like. So we're gonna wrap up here. And then once we start getting ready and heading out, we'll see you guys later. All right, you guys, we are all dressed up for Nicolette's surprise dinner. We're just waiting for the Uber right now, so once we get to the restaurant, I'll show you guys around.
We're taking Nicolette to a restaurant that's hanging off the edge of a cliff, literally. Offering panoramic views of the Pacific, the cliff serves up not just its food, but an experience of a lifetime.
Alright you guys, we're here. So we're at Nicolette in Puerto Vallarta. The ambiance is really nice, but let me show you the real reason I wanted to take Nicolette here, you guys. Look. Check all that out. There's like a little terrace down there too. But yeah, this is our little early Valentine's Day dinner since Valentine's Day falls on a Wednesday this year. So it's like a little special something something before then. We're gonna check out the menu, order, and then once the food comes, then we'll show you guys what that's about.
All right, so Nicolette got the piña colada and I got a virgin strawberry daiquiri because I don't drink. Also, when they gave us the waters, they let us pick whether we wanted pineapple, cucumber, grapefruit, and lemon in it. So that's pretty cool too. But yeah, cheers. Valentine's Day. You guys, look. Oh my God, there's another one right there.
Bye, have a great time.
Hi. Hi, little guy, it's okay. I won't hurt you. Oh no, okay. I won't hurt you, it's okay. I'm just gonna pass. I'm just passing. I'll take a picture of you.
Look, you guys, there was one, two, three. This is their seafood tapa. This is a grilled octopus taco. We have an oyster right here. We have a little stick thing right here, I'm not sure what that is. And then we have a coconut shrimp on a stick.
All right, everyone, We're gonna release a full review of this place on another video, but this concludes our day one festivities. Would you eat that torta that we had? Let us know in the comments below. We can't wait to show you what's next, so don't miss out. Tap that like, subscribe, and bell button below. Till next time, hasta luego, amigos!